Good morning, children. How are you all? All are fine. Okay. Yesterday, done all your homeworks. Okay. Come on. Open your studios, all of you. See the page number 111. So yesterday, what we learned, children? We learned about the new chapter. What is the topic? Is volume. What is called a volume, children? Yes, the area. The space occupied by the solid shape is called its volume. The space occupied by its solid shape is called its volume. And next, what we learn? Volume of a cube. What is the volume of a cube, children? Length into length. Why? Because cube has all sides are equal. That's why we are taking length into length. Okay, ma'am. Next, open your page number 111 in studio. See this one. The length of this stool is 50 centimeter. What is its volume? See here, stool is given. See here, length is 50 centimeters, breadth 50 centimeter, and height also 50 centimeter given. So volume of this stool, what you have to do here? What you have to do? Yes, 50 into 50 into 50. Okay, ma'am. So what you have to write here? 50 into 50 into 50. Here you have some members yesterday done the homework. They are mistaken here. Write here units. Okay, ma'am? Write the units. So 50 into 50 into 50. How much? 5 is 25. 25 into 5. How much, children? Yes, 125. Here, how many zeros remaining? 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. And next, what you have to write, children? Cubic centimeters. Compulsory you have to write the units. Okay, cubic centimeters. Already we are given, but we are not yet given which you have to write. Compulsory you have to write the square units. Okay, ma'am. Cubic units. Okay, this is the volume is. What is the measure of units? Cubic. Okay, ma'am. Next, let us find the volume of the cuboid given in figure 4. See here, figure 4 given. Number of unit cubes along the length. How many unit cubes along the length here? 3. Right here? 3. Number of unit cubes along the breadth. Breadth, how many cubes are there here? 2. Right here? 2. Number of unit cubes along the height. Height, how many cubes are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Right here? 4. Okay, ma'am. So, volume of the cuboid is length how much? 3, breadth 2, height 4. So, 4, 3 into 2 into 4 equal to how much? Dash cubic centimeters. Here, centimeters given, no? So, 3 to 6, 6 4, 24 cubic centimeters. Okay, ma'am? Come on, right. Next, turn the page number 112. For any given cuboid, the number of cubes in each stack is length into breadth. See here, how many stacks are there here? 1, 2, 3. Okay. Since the number of stacks is given by the height of the cuboid, the total number of cubes is length into breadth into height. Length, breadth, height. So, what is the volume of cuboid formula, children? Length into breadth into height. Okay. In the volume of cube, all sides are equal means it is length into length. But here volume of cuboid is length into breadth into height. Next, see this activity. Name one object you use that you wish was bigger in volume. Why? So you have to take any one object. What you have to use? Bigger volume. That one you have to write here. Okay. And next, name one object you use that you wish was smaller in volume. Which one is the smaller in volume? That one you have to write. What is the reason you have to write? Suppose tiffin box is there. In the tiffin box, we are kept the tiffins whole box. Okay. So, that is the larger volume. So, the bigger volume. Okay. And the smaller volume is pencil box. We are keeping only pencils. Okay. That is the smaller volume. Like that you have to write here. Okay. I am telling only examples. You have to write anyone. Okay. That is the homework for you. And next, open your companion. Page number 47. See here, each rack on the given shelf is in the shape of a cube. See here, this one is a shelf is given in the shelf. Racks are given here. That is in the shape of a cube. Each cube can hold 600 sheets of paper. So each cube hold how many papers? 600 sheets of paper. How many sheets of paper can the shelf hold together? So this shelf, whole shelf, how many sheets of paper hold all together? You have to find it. Okay. See here, total number of racks in the shelf. So you have to count it. How many number of racks are there? Count it and write it here. The number of sheets of paper that one rack on the shelf can hold. So one rack can hold how many sheets of paper? Right here. We are given now 600. So write here 600. Next, the number of sheets of paper that the shelf can hold. So now, this whole shelf can hold how many sheets of paper? That means what you have to write here? How many shelves are there? How many racks are there here? 16 into, for each rack, how many sheets of paper hold it? 600. 16 into 600. Do it. And do the multiplication, that will get the answer. Okay, ma? That is the homework for you. Okay, ma? Can you understand? So, what we learned today? Volume of a cuboid. What is the volume of a cuboid formula? Length into breadth into height. Okay, children, we will continue tomorrow, children. Goodbye. Have a nice day.